Hey everyone, it is Havel High here, bringing another video on Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle. In this video, we are going to be talking about the news on JP. That's right, the upcoming transformation cooler and a bunch of other stuff is going to be coming out as well in this new campaign. So we're going to go ahead and break all that down for you. So with that, if you are new to my channel, like, subscribe, comment below, do all that good stuff. And this is exciting here for JP players. Global, hey, you know what? We'll get our stuff a little bit later. But let's go ahead and jump into the news here. Now, I am still under the weather, so I'm going to sound funny. Going to have a little sniffles here. But anyway, I just did a Google Translate on all this, pretty much. And this is going to be the Dokkan Rally campaign. So let's go ahead and jump into the Dokkan Rally campaign, which basically runs until this is 10:31, but it's today in the West Coast. I'm in California here. It's already the 31st in Japan, so it's going to go run from 10:31 to 11:21. So quite a bit some time on the celebration here, which is normal, right? Normal here, about 3 weeks, and it should be really, really fun. And this right here should really tell us when the Super Dragon Ball Heroes banner is going to be dropping. Probably right around 11:21 or 11:22. So expect Super Dragon Ball Heroes to be jumping right around that time. All right, so let's go ahead and jump into this here. There's gonna have like weekly different missions here, 1, 2, 3. So from the first weekly mission is from 10:31 to 11:07, and then the second one 11:08 to 11:14, 11:15 to 11:21, and then some daily missions on that is on top of that as well. So interesting, they're doing that, which is nice. It just keeps it a little bit fresh and a little bit different every single week, so you don't have to do the same thing over and over again for 3 weeks. So, but here's really everyone's being hyped for this unit here is incredible. I'll be doing a breakdown a little bit later, so definitely check that out. But transforming strength cooler is what I'm, you know, this type of leader has been already introduced. We just didn't know this was going to be a part of the new meta, and this is what I'm going to be calling the new meta, is the passive support leaders. All right, and what I mean by passive support leaders is having a 170% or even 150% category lead or a top tier leader skill along with a passive support skill, because we have the Future Gohan with the same thing, amazing 170% category, then some support benefits in the passive. So, and Cooler's the same way. And of course, the introduction of the mono teams, the mono leaders, the support leaders there. So that's where it seems like where Dokkan's going to go. So I think we're going to get the new meta is support passive leaders that are just incredible. And so this is going to run from 10:31 to 11:21, so the full campaign we're going to be able to summon for the transforming cooler. So really amazing there. We're going to also have a you know, of course, a category gotcha here. So Dragonstone cells, I don't really use too much anymore on my JP account, but for those who need to buy these, good luck on hopefully having a great super sale here to help you guys all out. Here is the Dokkan event for the cooler. This is for to get the medals to Dokkan Awaken. This is the free-to-play tech cooler here. So so that's a unit if you do want to run the new Conquest of Terror category, you're able to do that as a free-to-play. We also have a new Extreme Z area, and this I haven't really covered yet, but the OG, the ones that you start with, like the free, you know, summon for Goku, Gohan, and Piccolo, you're gonna get an Extreme Z Awakening area to complete and get the medals for this hero Extreme Z area event here. So pretty nice here, and these units are okay, you know, they're not. I think that Gohan and Goku and Vegeta and Trunks, those units are better, but yeah, they're, once again, when you EZA something, they're going to be still good. This is actually interesting info here that the Hero Extermination, it says, is going to be indefinite. So this might be the introduction of Hero Exterminations available from here on out and not having to wait until the weekend, which will be nice. Nice for JP players. This is the Goku and Arali. So if you haven't gotten this, if you're new new player or just haven't had the grind yet that's going to have all three stages returning there, along with Super Dragon Ball or Dragon Ball Super Broly, this campaign coming back. So if you haven't got Coats, Goku, or Vegeta yet, Super Saiyan Blue version, great units to get, all free to play here. So really nice for free to plays to return these, and you don't have to use keys. You can, you know, do the buff up and everything. So all good. Elder Kai banner here. This is going to be some special missions as well. And then the 20th battlefield is coming up. So we don't know what the details is on the enemies. Hopefully they're going to make it even harder, or maybe do a regular version and then maybe extreme version or something like that. Who knows? But Battlefield is still, you know, fun and something to do to get some free items and things of that nature. Then the weekend banner is going to be dropping for JP. Global already has the weekend banner, so that's going to be good here. This is going to actually run till the 24th. A few more days after the celebration is over. So when Super Dragon Ball Heroes banner drops, this will almost end here. So and then this is basically just saying we got the weekend missions and stuff like that. So and here it is. Here is the EZA that we're going to get in this campaign. And I think everybody was guessing this correctly, that it's going to be Strength Omega Shenron, the second to last God Lead before Super Vegito, which is going to break the game somehow like it did originally. So it's going to be interesting to see what the Omega Shenron is going to look like. So that's introduced right here, along with the return of the Tech Beerus EZA, which means probably what's going to happen is we're going to get a EZA to the secondary Beeruses, like Strength Beerus and things of that nature. So look out for that. But Omega Shenron is what we're looking for, but it'll be nice to get a Strength Beerus EZA because he's, you know, totally worthless, and possibly the Int Beerus as well. So Int and Strength Beerus. So if you don't know, when these return, sometimes they provide medals to EZA, you know, the secondary units. So we'll see if Int and Strength get a little upgrade. And then these are the EZA battles, and then the return of some GT missions here. So revamping on maybe some of those, and then the Battle of the Gods. So that is it. We might get a part two in this. Maybe part two is, I don't know, LR banner of some sort. That could be the case, but we know for sure, you know, I'm like 99% sure on the 21st we are going to be getting Super Dragon Ball Heroes, and that's going to be pretty hype because, you know, Golden Cooler is going to be on it, and that's going to, you know, hopefully link well with this transformation cooler as well. So that is the news, boys and girls. Are you excited? Let me know in the comment section below. If you are new to my channel, like, subscribe, do all that good stuff. And if you're an OG, I continue to thank you for your support. Hit that notification button to stay up to date with the latest videos. So with that, thank you all for watching. Keep on Dokkaning, and we will catch you next time. Later.